shall we? This is the first look at the Razer Orochi mobile gaming mouse. This mouse currently has 8200 DPI running off a 4G laser sensor. It can be used as a USB wired, however the wire is only around about 1 meter, just over 3 foot. It also has up to 7 months of battery life. Sounds a lot. If it can be done, I don't know, on 2 AAA batteries, I guess if you use the software which Razer gives you, which is the Synapse 2.0, and if you set the light to dim or off, and maybe had the mouse set to turn itself off after 1 minute of being idle, I guess you could probably would be able to get 7 months worth of battery life from it. If you turn the product on its side, it gives you a quick overview of a few things. The mouse itself being Bluetooth and wireless, and of course wired USB. The sensor itself at 8200 DPI, and of course shown again around about the 7 months of battery life. Moving on to the back, indicates section of numbers, again promoting wireless and wired. The new additions would be the ambidextrous form factor, the chroma lighting, and of course the 7 independently programmable buttons. On the other side then, picture of the mouse, description of gaming on the go, and finally a couple of icons again promoting the main features of this mouse. Okay, after opening the product up, you get a nice little thank you from Razer for buying their product, and of course stating that you'll never turn back to the dark side of the force, or Steel Series I guess, or Turtle Beach, or Logitech, Cooler Master, you name it, there's plenty out there. An instruction manual, 2 Razer stickers, pretty decent. And there's a small box inside that contains all your accessories. Very, very small. Very, very small bag. Not too bad, I guess. Some decent batteries, Duracell. 2 AA, so you don't have to go and buy yourself batteries. And of course, what I said about the 3 foot epoxy cable, and I mean that is 3 foot, it's the shortest cable I've ever seen in my life. And of course, the actual mouse itself. Here it is here. Oh, yeah. Check it out. It is dinky. Those are the new rubber sides on both sides. Buttons on both sides as well. So there, of course, a standard 2 buttons there, and a mouse button. Doesn't go that way or the other way. Size of it though, I say it's small. You know, look how small this is. Okay, my hands aren't now. Okay, my palm is actually resting on the floor. On, find my palms off it. That's resting quite comfortably on it. Usually, with any mouse, my palm is really set on it, like that. And the buttons about there, they are. As you can tell, I can't do this mouse. Too small. So overall, if you're looking for a mobile mouse that's small, unique, powerful, you know, works really, really well, then you cannot go wrong with this mouse. However, big-handed, giant hands, fat fingers, or anything like that, maybe this mouse is not for you. But you can read more about this mouse, and of course the original Orochi, in my review coming soon, only on invisioncommunity.co.uk.